Hello guys, good evening. As it's Monday, so let's do our Forex Weekly Analysis. First, let's discuss about dollar index chart, and then we'll move to individual currencies and we'll try to see which currency is looking strong for this week and which one is weak, so that we can correlate and we can trade one strong one weak for this entire week. Talking about commodities, we'll also discuss about gold and oil. So let's first start with dollar index. So as you can see, we expected dollar to go up and it exactly went that way. It is still looking to be on the buying side also. If you see continuously, if you see the way the candle is forming, it's clearly indicating for a buy. And again, I'll draw my same channel because that is being respected from a long period of time. So I'm still following this one channel itself. And this is where I'm targeting. I'm expecting the market to reach till the price of 100. And 100 is also a psychological level. So this itself becomes a very strong resistance. So still after some pullback, as it's Monday, I would continue to be on the buying side of dollar. If you already have trades, you can hold on. If you have booked your profits after pullback, you can look to re-enter. So I'm clearly very strong on dollar this week as well. So starting with Euro-USD, so Euro-USD, if you can notice the chart, it's a clear bearish body dominating candle. If you are having this trade, you can hold on. If not, you can see this is a proper clear trend line here we have. And if we, instead of a trend line, you can draw a channel. And if you see the entire movement, it still has scope to fall till here. If you follow Fibonacci, then you can clearly draw a Fibonacci from this low to this high and see my level is around 78.6. It's coinciding around that. So once it breaks, then market has a possibility to go down till 88.6, so which is coinciding with the trend line. So overall way the candle has closed, so as it's playing above 78.6, there's a slight possibility it can take some time to come down, might do some pullback and then it might fall. But overall, if you see, it looks like a strong sell confirmation. You can extend this trend line till here as well. It becomes, the more the past data you can extend it, the stronger it becomes. If you remember, I keep saying that. So yeah, I'm expecting it to fall till at least till here. So Euro USD a strong sell, but wait for proper pullback in a smaller time frame and then you can look to sell. So Euro USD looks like a clear sell. Now if you see GBP, so GBP has closed like a bullish candle, which means GBP in itself is strong against dollar. Okay, if you would have noticed, Euro USD had a clear correlation, Euro weak and dollar strong, or maybe dollar is just dollar is strong, that's why Euro USD as a pair is looking like a sell. But GBP USD is looking bullish in despite of dollar being strong, which means GBP USD in itself as a currency is very strong. And I can also clearly see a trend line here. You can extend this again, as I said. You can extend it further, you can extend it even further. So it is becoming stronger and stronger. So if you see, this is a very strong trend line which is acting as a support. This moving average is also acting as a support. Now if you draw Fibonacci also, it should be coinciding around 38.2. See, it's exactly coinciding. So this becomes a confluence area. And it's also like a piercing formation or a harami pattern. More than piercing, it's more like a harami pattern. Which shows indecision but at the support, right? So it looks like a buy to me, and which clearly shows GBP in itself is very strong and Euro is weak. So Euro GBP as a chart should be a very good sell. See, you can clearly see with the weekly close, and as in when the pullback happens, it should be a strong sell because Euro we are bearish, GBP we are bullish. So Euro GBP as a pair should just fall down. Already you can see it's in a downward trend. It looks like it has done the pullback and it should fall. And I'm expecting a vertical fall. Reason being, if you see the similar time, if you see there was a vertical move on the upside, so this fall also I'm expecting vertical, so it could be a huge fall. So GBP, Euro GBP should be a very strong trade this week. As in when you see some pullback, you should be on the sell side. Now let's move to New Zealand USD. So New Zealand USD, if you see weekly chart, though dollar became strong, still New Zealand has indecisive candle, which means it is trying to gain strength a little. Also, you can see a trend line forming, something like this. Or if you are not able to draw, you can draw it like this as well. Okay, if you are not convinced, if you are not able to see trend lines, then you can draw a Fibonacci, which is from support, swing low to swing high. See, it's exactly taking a support of 61.8, and also market has a trend line here. So there is a possibility. It's not like GBP that GBP USD is clearly indicating for a buy, which shows a very strong strength of GBP. Here it shows indecision, which means New Zealand and USD both are equally on the stronger side. So that's why there's a spinning top. So what I would say is you can expect some pullback. But eventually, if dollar becomes strong, then New Zealand USD can be on the downside. Same thing you can notice with AUD USD. AUD USD, see, it's a small half body, half wick, but half body is a bullish candle. It's though it hasn't completed the evening star, it would have been an evening star if the candle would have closed above 50% of this. So, but still it is slowly picking momentum. So if next candle close bullish, then it can be a start of a bullish movement also. So AUD and New Zealand are trying to gain strength, but it's not as strong as GBP, and they are not weak as Euro. So it's in between AUD and New Zealand. So in between AUD and New Zealand, which is most stronger, you can see by checking AUD NCD as a pair. AUD and NCD as a pair, you can clearly see a rejection. I will not call it as a pin bar because I have doubts that a tail is three times of the body. That we can check. If that is there, then it's a pin bar. Otherwise, also it's a rejection and it's a proper breakout pullback setup. So if you see, New Zealand looks stronger, AUD looks weaker. You can clearly figure out by this thing. So you should be on the sell side of AUD, or you should be, rather than on the sell side, you should be on the buy side of New Zealand. So New Zealand basically looks strong. So GBP and NCD both are on the stronger side. So which is more stronger? You can clearly see GBP. If you compare between GBP and New Zealand, which are both are on the strong side, but GBP looks more stronger. Clearly there's a bullish close. So out of all the pairs, if you compare GBP with anything, let's say with any currency, you can say, let's say GBP AUD here, it is indicating for a buy, right? It's a rejection and it is indicating for a buy. If you see GBP CHF, bullish. If you see GBP CAD, again a bullish close. So GBP overall is the strongest, then comes dollar and New Zealand, and then comes AUD. So these are all on the strong side. Euro looks weak to me. Let's check about oil now. Oil has clearly formed a bullish engulfing, you can say. It was falling down, but if you see exactly at the support, it is trying to go up now. Also, if you draw a Fibonacci from low to high, you can see it's still playing below 61.8, but overall, if you see, the candle has closed above 61.8, though it did went down. But overall, if you see, it is a support, it's acting as a support zone here. It tried to break the support, but it looks like it's bouncing back, or it's trying to do some pullback. So that's the overall scenario you can see. To have the clarity, you can just use this trend line. So you can expect it to go up and do the 50% pullback, and then you can again expect it to fall down. Another trend line what I can notice here is clearly is this one. Okay, you can draw a trend line like this. See, it was a resistance which did a breakout, and it more looks like a pullback, and then it can have a bullish momentum. So oil overall looks bullish. So Canadian dollar should also be on the buying side. Let's check USD CAD. So if you see, USD CAD has closed like a bearish candle, despite of the fact that dollar is strong, right? And why this has closed bearish? Because Canadian dollar is also strong and is more stronger than dollar, right? See here, Okay, so we have Canadian dollar also on the strong side and stronger than dollar. We have GBP also on the strong side, which is stronger than dollar. So you should always check GBP CAD as a pair. So if you check that, still GBP is looking bullish, which means out of all the pair, if I have to prioritize, GBP looks strongest, then comes Canadian dollar, then comes USD and New Zealand USD, then comes AUD. So most of the pairs are on the stronger side this week. Only Euro till now is looking weak. Now let's check USD JPY. So USD JPY also, if you see, it has a slight rejection at the resistance, because JPY is also looking on the stronger side. So all the pairs, if you notice this week, are more looking towards the stronger side. So individually these currencies have strength. It's all the pairs are not just dependent on dollar. Like GBP individually is strong, Canadian dollar individually is looking strong, and same goes with JPY also. So you can check CAD JPY. So CAD JPY, the way the candle has closed, it is overall indicating a buy for CAD JPY, which means CAD looks bullish, which means CAD is more stronger than JPY. You can also compare GBP JPY. Again, GBP JPY also should be looking, GBP is more stronger. So GBP JPY overall should look for a buy. I'll just add that symbol. GBP JPY is here. Okay, so if we open this, see, again it's looking bullish. So against strong pairs, JPY is looking weak, but against weak pair, like for example Euro JPY, should be a good sell because Euro is looking weak. See, so against weak pairs, JPY is strong. Against strong pairs, JPY is weak, right? But against dollar also, JPY is looking strong. So overall it's more on the stronger side. So that's the overall scenario of JPY. Let's check CHF. I think CHF should also be on the weak side. Euro and CHF I'm expecting. Let's check USD CHF as a chart. It's here. USD CHF, see here you can see it's clearly bullish, right? Dollar strong, CHF weak. So USD CHF overall looks like a very strong buy, and CHF also looks weak. So Euro and CHF are the only two pairs which are looking like on the weaker side. So you can check CHF against, let's check Euro CHF to check which one is more weak. Euro is more weak. We can clearly see a bearish candlestick. So overall, I have a scenario now in front of me after checking all the major pairs. I hope you're not getting confused. All you have to see individual currencies which are looking more stronger. So there are two strong pairs, let's say dollar and GBP. In between dollar and GBP, which is more stronger, GBP is more stronger. So that's what we are trying to figure out. So on the weak side, we have Euro. Euro is looking very weak, and CHF. CHF is on the second priority. That is also on the sell side. Apart from that, all six pairs are looking strong. Which means the highest will be, strongest is GBP, like I already mentioned. Then comes Canadian dollar, because oil is looking strong. We already discussed about this. So we expect oil to go up, which means Canadian dollar should go up. Then next is New Zealand and dollar. Both are looking equally strong, because we have an indecisive pattern. When we have a spinning top when we are talking about New Zealand USD. So both are on the stronger side. We also have JPY, which is looking strong. So which one is more stronger? We can check New Zealand JPY as a pair. So New Zealand JPY as a pair, again there's a rejection which is showing for more towards the sell, which is means JPY is comparatively more stronger. So I'll keep JPY a step forward, which means GBP is the strongest, then comes Canadian dollar, then comes JPY, then comes dollar and New Zealand, and then comes AUD. So AUD JPY also should be indicating, see, it's indicating for a sell. Though both are on the stronger side, but JPY looks more strong, and this looks like a clear setup. You can draw it like this. You can draw it like a channel. That would be better, because I noticed just now. See, this is a channel movement, breakout of the channel, pullback. It should be a good fall. So I hope I've summarized everything in a very clear way. And if you still have queries, you can always post it on the comment box and we'll try to cover up those currencies or commodities. Anything, please let us know and keep trading and keep following our videos to have an understanding of this week's direction. So this video is mainly for this week. Next week again we'll do the Monday analysis and we'll try to figure out what's the direction for the coming week. So thank you guys. Have a good trading week.